are about to connect with people who are ready to bring you the most open, honest, and revealing life stories. Welcome to JourneyTV. Hi, and welcome to JourneyTV. I'm Erlene Camille, your host, and I'm here today with Mitzie Turnquest. Mitzie, welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here today.
It's a pleasure.
So Mitzie, I've seen you over the years, you know, be a girl boss, you know, the empowered woman that you are. You're a motivational speaker. You're a stylist.
Yes.
Fashion consultant.
Yes.
And of course, you are an entrepreneur. You own Signature Styles.
Correct.
A company that's been booming for years.
Yes.
So I know what I know about Mitzie. Yes. How about you tell us more about you?
Well, there's so much more to say about Mitzie, but just to give you a bit of a background, I came from very humble beginnings. And so I grew up in a one-bedroom home. Mm-hmm. And I grew up with women who never passed beyond their high school education. So they were strong women. They were women who didn't have formal education, but they were women who birthed me and who groomed me. Mm-hmm. And so for the most part, I had very humble beginnings. So it was my humbling experience that literally cost me and forced me to birth so much greatness that I have achieved in my lifetime. Mm-hmm. So that's a lot of things that people don't know. I've had a lot of childhood ills, a lot of social ills, mm-hmm. that I've had to overcome throughout the years. And truth be told, you know, I'm still struggling. Mm-hmm. I'm still trying to work through those processing periods of my life, mm-hmm. truth be told. But those are the parts of me that a lot of people don't know. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes we see the strong woman, we mm-hmm. see the woman who's achieved so much greatness and so much success, but not understanding that the journey or the process that she had to go through mm-hmm. to achieve those success. Mm-hmm. And so for me, it was just trying to not so much submerge myself, but keep myself coming up, revolving and evolving. Mm-hmm. And it's always been about that constant growth, bounce back. You know, I've had to deal with divorce. I've had to deal with, like I said, childhood wounds. I've had to deal with just homelessness mm-hmm. and being just broke and, mm-hmm. and bankrupt mm-hmm. and knowing how to start all over again all by myself. And so, you know, people look at me and say, she's such a strong woman, but I had to learn to be strong. I wasn't always strong. Mm-hmm. So that's my story, mm-hmm. you know.
And I know I've heard a lot of your story.
Yes.
And the point that keeps hitting home for me is the period that you talk about when you were homeless. You just
Correct.
Mentioned it a few minutes ago.
Yes.
And I know that you've mentioned before that, you know, that humbled you.
It did.
Help us to understand that process, you know, that humbling process, and how that helped you then and how it's helping you now.
You know, I believe that in our lifetimes that all of our Goliaths, all of the challenges that comes our way, it's not there to literally destroy us, it's there to help us birth and show who we really are. Mm-hmm. And so for me, it was like the lowest point of my life.
Wow.
And it was then that I developed my personal creed, and I live by this. If you're not changing it, you're choosing it.
Wow.
And that's what I live by. If I'm not changing it, I'm choosing it. Mm-hmm. So I could have chose to stay down. I could have chose to stay in the mess that I was in. Mm-hmm. But I pulled myself up. And I said, no, you can't choose this road. This is not the road for you. And so being homeless for me was hard. It was the hardest and the lowest point in my life. Mm-hmm. And you know, you always get in those situations in your life where there's no one to turn to.
Wow.
And God always puts you in those isolated situations where you have to look up to Him. And sometimes that's hard to do when you depending on your friends or you're depending on family, but literally no one is there. Mm-hmm. And so it was that period of my life that I had to learn to depend on me and depend on God alone. And so that's what had made me to be so strong. That's what had showed me my strength. Mm-hmm. And it was only through those darkest time in my life where I slept in my car for 3 days. Mm-hmm. People don't know that. I was 25 years old, I slept in my car.
Wow.
And I was such at a low point in my life that there were many times I actually bought a bleach and I wanted to just drink it. I just wanted to give up. Because to me, there was no hope. And I always say, share this with people, if you take hope away from a man, you destroy mm-hmm. a man. Mm-hmm. And so for me, I had to find my voice. I had to find myself. And in doing that, I was able to just find my way back slowly but surely. I was able to seek help. And I'm a believer that wherever God gives vision, He makes provision. But you have to find that vision.
Mm-hmm.
You have to put on paper exactly what it is that you want. Mm-hmm. And that's what I did. In 3 days in my car, sleeping and crying, I cried out to God and I said, I need help. Wow. I can't do this by myself.
Wow.
And I found help. I found him. Mm-hmm. I heard him. Mm-hmm. And I was able to get up on that trailer in my car. And I was able to find a place that was able to rent for $200. And I stayed there and I just was able to just grow my way back out. I was able to climb my way back out of a shell. And I always tell people this, you can't touch a woman who's learned to crawl her way back out on her own. Mm-hmm. You can mess her up, you can't do anything to her. Mm-hmm. And it was even in that process and period that I was delivered from people. Because wow. for me, it was the lowest point in my life. I couldn't care what people say or think mm-hmm. about me. Mm-hmm. And so God had delivered me from people. And so even at this process in my life where I'm at, it doesn't matter what people think or say. Mm-hmm. I'm not looking to be honored or to be celebrated by people. If I'm looking to be celebrated by God and God mm-hmm, alone.
Mm-hmm. Well, we still celebrate you. I mean, just the way you deliver your message, it's so powerful on so many different levels. You naturally motivate and inspire people as soon as you open your mouth.
Thank you, Arlene. I appreciate that.
So, talking about the homelessness, you said you were able to find God.
Yeah.
It sounds like you have an internal fight in you as well.
I do.
As you have strong faith.
I do.
For someone who may not be as strong and they are feeling hopeless, what would you tell them? Like, how can they dig deep to get on the path that you were able to get on?
There's two things. I always believe when you find a praying woman, you find a woman who persevere. Mm-hmm. I believe that with all my heart. Mm-hmm. Whenever I see a woman who prays, whether she's young or old, I see a woman who persevere. It's impossible for you to want to achieve greatness or want to achieve anything and not have a spiritual life. That doesn't even make sense to me. Mm-hmm. So whenever I see a person who is on that road to greatness, I know that you have a deep prayer life. Mm-hmm. That's important because guess what? I always say this to people. Greatness comes with a price. You can't get there by taking an elevator. There's no elevator to success. Mm-hmm. You're gonna have to walk each and every one of those steps. Mm-hmm. And you gotta be okay with being inconvenienced while you're doing that. And so anybody who's used to being inconvenienced, you have a prayer life. You have a spiritual walk. Mm-hmm. I know that for a fact. Mm-hmm. And I always like to tell people, I like to hear what people, see, when you see a mountain, people don't understand, mountains are formed through earthquakes. So I wanna know what your earthquake was. What did you have to go through? Because you couldn't go through that alone. You needed that. You needed the something in you. Mm-hmm. You needed God to help you survive that, to mm-hmm. hold your hand through that mm-hmm. process. So for me, I have a praying mom. My mom is one of those mothers who, she's an old-time Christian. My son always says she's the save Christian. So she's one of those people who prayed from morning, from sunset to sunup. So I grew up in a spiritual background. I know the power of God. Mm-hmm. I know the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. Mm-hmm. And so even though I had strayed into the world, in going into the world, we always find back our foundation. We always come back to what's worked for us. Mm-hmm. And so for me, for any person who is going through any challenges in their lives, I always say to them, just pray.
Just pray.
Just pray. Find your place. See, we so like crowds and people. You have to find your place of isolation where you can have that conversation with God and God alone. Mm-hmm. You have to find that inner peace. And so even for me right now, even though I wear many hats, I find that place in my home mm-hmm. that I have to spend time alone with God. That's mm-hmm. so important and vital mm-hmm. to me. Mm-hmm. I do that.
Yeah. So we're going to take a quick commercial break and come right back to finish this conversation with Mitzie.
We know you missed us. We missed you too. Bowflex Barbie here, and I'm so excited to let you know that Morning Moves is coming back to RTV Channel 212. Starting September 7th, every Monday and Wednesday at 6 and 9 a.m. and Saturday at 8 and 10 a.m., you'll get to sweat with me right from the comfort of your home. Be sure to tune in for my fun and exciting workouts and health tips from our wellness experts. Join me for Morning Moves, the perfect way to start your day.
Bring your backyard to life with Farmer Mackie. Handpicked fruits, herbs, and vegetables can be yours. Secure freshness and quality by letting us help you start your own backyard farm. With customized planters, compost soil, and your personalized selection of plants. Clean and quick installations are completed by our experienced team, who is committed to bringing you quality products and best care practices. Happy farming with Farmer Mackie.
For the Love of Events is a full event planning company that specializes in destination and local weddings, corporate and special events. We work with you on budget, venues, and vendor selections, design concepts, and so much more. So give us a call today at 801-4853 or send us an email to info@fortheloveofevents to book your free 30-minute virtual consultation. Be sure to check us out on Instagram and Facebook at For the Love of Events. We're Team 4TLE.
Hey guys, Bowflex Barbie here, and today I'm introducing you to my newest product, Barbie Bands. Barbie Bands are a set of four mini loop resistance bands, each with their own different resistance level. Barbie Bands are perfect for targeting and activation of the muscles, and they also are good for strengthening and toning them. Barbie Bands are the perfect addition to your gym bag, your home workout collection, and of course, they're super convenient to travel with too. Be sure to visit BowflexBarbie.com or your nearest Fitness Connection location in Freeport or Nassau to grab your set today.
Since 2013, Elite Wellness Solutions has been working with companies to reduce healthcare costs, increase productivity, and boost staff morale and energy. Our employee wellness programs guide employees towards healthier, happier, and more productive lives at home, at work, and in their communities. Contact us today so that we can schedule your free consultation with one of our corporate wellness specialists, and we can start building a culture of wellness within your organization.
Journey TV presents the most open, honest, and revealing life stories. These stories of survival and strength will inspire you because there is freedom and healing in every story. Join me and my guest every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. and Sunday at 5:30 p.m. during the month of August on RTV Channel 212 for real life conversations. Journey TV, we share life's truths.
Welcome back to Journey TV. We're going to finish up this conversation with Mitzie. So Mitzie, right before the break, we were talking about your journey through working through homelessness and your first step with giving advice to those who may be, you know, stuck in a place of hopelessness was to pray.
Yes.
What else would you offer?
Well, there's two more steps I'd like to add to that, too. That's so vital and so important. At the end, we talk about being delivered from people. That's so important. Mm-hmm. But something that's crucial for so many of us, and that is being a people's pleaser. I'm a recovering people's pleaser, I'll tell you that. I'm the first to tell people that. I'm a recovering people's pleaser.
Wow.
And that right there is so, so important for us to release and to be able to heal from, because throughout our life, it's a nurtured behavior. We've always been nurtured to compete and compare with everyone else. And so we grow up trying to edit and fix everything about ourselves. We're never good enough. We compare our lives, we compare our relationships, we compare our kids to everybody else. Mm. And so we grow up trying to please people, trying to edit ourselves. And so for me, the second step would be to stop being a people pleaser. Embrace who you are. You know what I mean? Appreciate what God has made, because God don't make mistakes. And so for me, I had to learn to love me. Mm-hmm. I had to accept me, because truth be told, I was never, when I grew up, I was always too small. I was too skinny. My hair was too picky. It was always something.
Always something.
I grew up in that environment that taught me that I was not good enough. Mm-hmm. And so I had to learn to almost not so much love myself, but appreciate me for who I was and embrace that. And so that took a process for me to do. And then the third step was a pen and paper, a simple pen and paper for me. It was picking that up every single day and understanding that you have to write your vision down. You have to put that on pen and paper and you have to place that before you. Mm-hmm. And I believe in this method so much. As simple as it may be, it's powerful. You place that in the one room you spend most of your time. Many people know I spend most of my time in my closet. That's where I spend most of my time. So all over my closet, if you walk into my closet, you'll see all of these visions because I believe so solely in that. It's a constant reminder of the things that I have to work on daily. Mm-hmm. It's a constant reminder of the things that I have to achieve. It never lets me forget. And so I build from that. The minute I walk into my closet, I realize that this is still outstanding and that is still outstanding. And so you know what? My day when I write my journal and what I have to accomplish, I build from that. Mm-hmm. That's important. That's the only way you're going to achieve what you want to achieve. Mm-hmm. You have to set some guidelines, some plan. Mm-hmm. And so I had to crawl myself back out of that. It took me a while, because it was just not personal development, but it was also professional development that needed in order for me to come to achieve where I am today. Mm-hmm. So those three steps are
those
so important.
Three steps,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
How do you remain consistent with following those plans? Because I do the same thing,
right.
But I have to admit, consistency is, let's say 2 weeks in or something happens to throw you off.
Yeah. Let me tell you what it is. It's removing distractions. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, that's the biggest problem. Mm-hmm. The biggest enemy of time is distraction.
Mm-hmm.
This phone that we have,
yeah,
that tool right there,
I
promise you not. You don't know when the time gets away from you. So you have to sometimes unplug. take yourself a lot of all of these social sites that causes you to put attention on it. I do that at least for a while. As of now, I'm off of all social sites. So I shut down because I need the distraction to be removed away. And that's the only way you're going to find the time to pour into yourself and to pour into your goals. If you don't, you're going to find that time is going to run away from you. Before you know it, the year is gone and you haven't accomplished anything. So for me, I feel as if though the distraction, and then you have to be consistent.
Yeah.
So I always make that commitment that 15 books a year I have to read.
15 books a year?
15 books a year.
Wow.
I have to read those books. And there's two books I read every year religiously.
I don't change them.
What
are they?
And that's Napoleon Hill, of course, Think and Grow Rich. And of course, Commanding Your Morning by Cindy Trim.
Wow.
Those two are like my book Bibles.
So every time you read them, you get something new.
I get
new
a new revelation.
Because you're at a different space in
Absolutely,
your life?
Absolutely. A different phase in my life. So it's like a new revelation is birthed into me. And I begin to sow that into my spirit. So those are my marathon books. Those are the books that keeps me
marathon
so focused.
Marathon books.
Absolutely. They keep me focus, they keep me driven, and they make me understand. And then I believe that I have four eyes looking back at me. I have two sons. And I believe that at the end of the day, they shouldn't look outside of me to be a role model. They should see that right there in their
right
home.
There. Yeah.
I want to be like my mom. And so I live that life that they're able to look at and say, I don't talk a game. I live that life. So I can't say to my son, read a book if I'm not reading a book. I think that's pure hypocrisy. So I read for him to understand the importance of reading. And so it's easier for him to mimic that because that's what he sees. Children do what they see, not what you tell them to do.
This is true.
Yeah. The one thing I would like to say to all of our viewers, and of course, you know, whether it be man or woman, is simply this. You know, if you are aggressive, stay assertive. If you're bold, stay bold. You know, create fire in yourself, create revolution. Don't seek permission from people to be you. Don't look for seasons in your life. Don't look for the right time in your life. You just do it. There's no reason why you should say, you know what, I don't have the monies, I don't have the resources. No, I promise you not. Just start it. Just start it. And I believe, I'm a big believer that wherever God gives vision, he makes provision. In fact, I'm a product of it. So once you put it down and you write it down and you present it, just go and just run with it. You'll be surprised how many doors open for you. But you got to start. And stop making excuses in your life. Start looking at the positive and stop looking at the negative. And that's the few words I want to leave with the audience.
Okay, so your feedback for, again, people who are feeling hopeless, they're in different situations. Your situation was during a certain period you were homeless.
Yes.
So that was praying.
Yes.
Don't be a people pleaser because you have to focus on your life and do what you have to do. And then also to journal your plan and be consistent with carrying out that plan
every day.
That was great advice.
Yes,
thank you so much, Mitzie. I mean, the thing is, there's so many more to share.
Yes.
So for our viewers, we have to bring you back.
Okay,
we have to bring you back.
I'll be on it too.
Well, thank you so much sharing your journey with us, sharing, you know, the lowest point in your life and how you got over it and giving us the advice that you've given us. Thank you for joining us. Stay tuned to more Journey TV.
All of our guests have released exclusive life stories on Footprints blog. Log on to www.footprintsjourney.net to learn more and to continue to follow their journeys of survival, resiliency, and strength. Follow at Footprints on Facebook and on Instagram at Footprints Journey. Contact us at joinus@footprintsjourney.net if you have an inspirational life story to share.
We want
you
to journey with us.
Footprints!
Nkosi Kwaku-Simonet, CEO and Operations Manager at Sign Island. Sign Island started from desperation. My wife went ahead and bought the first printer. I still have no idea how we are where we are. I owe it all to my staff and my customers. You need support. One man is not an island. You can't do it on your own. If you think you can do it on your own and you are succeeding, you can do even more with a little bit of support. The support I've got from my clients has been amazing.
Fitness Connection is the essence of Superman is strong when you can get any Superman.
The Fitness Connection is basically where it's at.
I always receive that homely, friendly service.
Me, they treat me like family.
Every transaction and interaction that we've had with your business has been extremely pleasant.
Your communication is impeccable. Your service is amazing. We just want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Fitness Connection.
Do you want to empower your team to achieve more, increase productivity and revenue, and while having lots of fun doing it? Then bring in Nathan L. Sweeting to speak at your event or to facilitate a workshop. His high energy and focus on mindset changes is exactly what your organization needs. Just go to NathanLSweeting.com or call 447-7864 to book him and empower your team today.
It's time for Journey TV's Community Highlight, where we feature nonprofits that are giving back to our community in big ways. These local heroes are positively impacting and changing our nation by their give back. Our goal is to bring more awareness and support to their organizations to assist with their continual service to our Bahamas. Here is this week's feature.
Hi everyone, I'm Siesca Adderley. I am the founder of the Give Back Girl organization. But in order for me to tell you what the Give Back Girl organization is, I'm gonna take it back to how it got started or how it evolved. So one Christmas, my family and I decided rather than give each other gifts, we would pool our resources to give back to a community or a small group of people and bring Christmas cheer to them. And so that initiative was spearheaded by my auntie Ethne. And so we would do that, we were doing that for a number of years. And then in 2016, we were planning to do our give back. And we were dealt a devastating blow. My auntie Ethne, the one that spearheaded our give back initiative, actually passed away just a few weeks before we were scheduled to do our initiative. So at that point, we were at a crossroads. And so in 2017, we decided, this would have been a year after Hurricane Matthew, and I remember going in to Los San Andres and just being incredibly saddened about what was happening and how they had lost so much. And then so I wondered a year later, is anybody even remembering them? Because we would have gone back to business as usual. So my family and I decided that we were going into Los San Andres and we would have done a Christmas party for the children in that community. And we also would have given out care packages to the elderly in that community. So that was in 2017. And then in 2018, it was actually my Aunt Simone, it was her idea. Because, you know, cancer, a lot of people always focus on the patients themselves and their recovery, but no one really takes the time to understand or look after or, you know, even understand the role that the caregiver has. And so in 2018, we decided that we were going to treat 10 cancer caregivers to a spa day at the Nail Lounge. So that was food, drinks, massages, manis, pedis, just to give them an afternoon off because they do so much for others and people don't recognize what it is that they do. So that's what we did in 2018. And then in 2019, as you know, Hurricane Dorian hit and no one could have imagined the devastation that that would have caused. And so I felt the need to go into those communities. And then I was guided by, you know, my mom, my dad, and my aunt, those, and they said, well, where are you gonna stay? What are you gonna do? People are coming out of these communities and coming to Nassau. So then we decided that, hey, when you think about children and what they would be going through, it's hard for them to grasp, you know, this new normal that they would now be in, because a lot of them were displaced from their families. A lot of them would have lost their parents in the storm. So we decided that we would invite all of the children throughout all the children's homes to a giant Christmas party. And so we had a big Christmas party for them at New Providence Community Church last year. And so based on that, that was our biggest give back today, because we would have reached over 200 kids. And so just in that, I realized that this was bigger than a one-off. We're spreading Christmas cheer as a family to these small groups. This is something that's gonna have to be ongoing and we're gonna have to do what we can to help. And so that brings me in a long, very roundabout way to really what the Give Back Girl is. And really, it's just a family and family friends. We have now come together and we want to spread cheer to any member of the family. So as I would have said, we helped various members of the family already. So we would have done things for the elderly. We would have done things for the young. We would have done things for, you know, men and women. So really it's just about any member of the family and we're about spreading cheer at any point. So our what we're known for is doing it at Christmas time, but what COVID-19 has taught us in 2020, the movement continues and we have to expand our reach. So we're now at the point where we are working towards becoming a nonprofit organization, and we're just trying to help and bring cheer and impact families. So that's the give back girl. My family and I, we may drive the initiative, but that's how we look at everybody that ever comes on board and assists us in any way possible. We are family. And so the more members in the family that get their hands dirty, the more people we can impact. So we don't have official pages yet, but look for that. That's coming soon. But you can reach out to me on Facebook, Siesca Adderley. You can also reach out to me on Instagram. That's Miss Lauren Ad 84 at Instagram. You can also email me at Siesca, that's SCIESKA.ADD@gmail.com. And you can also call me at 468-1934. Volunteers are welcome, sponsorships are welcome, everybody is welcome, because the movement continues and we want you to be a part of that. And as we like to say, from the Give Back Girl, from my heart to yours.
Women's Haven, providing 100% organic feminine products, including sanitary pads, which help customers with...
I have no irritation during my cycle.
The Yoni Detox Pearls and Steam, which customers have said...
Definitely less pain during my period.
And the Yoni Herbal Wash and Oil, which can...
reduces odor and leaves me feeling clean.
To find out more about the products, visit www.womenshaven.com. Make the switch. Your body will thank you.
Balmoral Club is a membership club where at the core of our product offering is a lifestyle that includes tranquility, serenity, and security. This is supported by unparalleled amenities and services. We invite you to become a member of Balmoral Club today, where you can experience the best of everything. Feel free to contact us at 302-4236 or membership@balmoralclub.com.
Now more than ever, people are looking for ways to improve their health, fitness, and overall well-being. Morning Moves is a daily exercise show hosted by the Bahamas Queen of Fitness, Bowflex Barbie. Viewers will get to join in a fun and exciting workouts right from the privacy of their homes. Each episode will also have a health and lifestyle segment where wellness experts help viewers live healthier and more fulfilling lives. Starting Monday, September 7th, Morning Moves will air every Monday and Wednesday morning at 6 and 9 a.m. and Saturday mornings at 8 and 10 a.m. right here on Our TV, Channel 212. Be sure to tune in, because there's nothing like it on local TV now, and we're giving you the opportunity to be a part of this new and exciting movement. Contact us today at 601-8198 or email mediasales@cablebahamas.com to learn how you can advertise or become a sponsor of the hottest new show in town. Morning Moves with Bowflex Barbie, the perfect way to start your day.
There are many times we find ourselves battling alone. Yes, we share life with our families and friends, but there are many situations that we have no other choice but to navigate alone. In this stillness and sometimes darkness of our aloneness, feelings of uncertainty, anxiety, and even fear can completely consume us. These times are hard, but it is when our greatest work is done. It is when we dig deep to search our inner selves for answers to get out of these painful holes. It is also when we look up and humbly open ourselves up to our Maker. Looking up is the best move we can make, because we find God's light, His hope, and His grace to help withstand our darkest moments. Through personal connection and prayer with your Heavenly Father, dark moments turn into light, and that is when we can see the way forward. One step turns into hope, then the other into strength, and the other into actions. With each step forward, we move closer to healing and being a better version of ourselves. And those dark moments become a powerful testimony of our journey. We can then, in turn, share that journey with someone else who is struggling and bring them hope and healing. Thank you for tuning in. Until next time, give light, hope, and love to the people around you. But most importantly, don't forget to give it to yourself.